Good morning.
Chairman sir, who is my esteemed teacher, Professor Chinnaswamy, Dr. Bhandari, Dr. Chibber, Dr. Kirpekar, and several teachers in the general surgery as well. I submit to you here in next 10 to 12 minutes my experience of converting from open surgeon to a robotic surgeon. And I must thank Dr. Bhandari. He was the one who really made me to go for it. Now, as you see, 1990 when we started radical prostatectomy program, the emphasis was only in cancer control, continence, and also the potency. However, as you come around to the next century, now we are talking about negative margins and absolutely no complications. And previous speakers addressed this issue, and I actually echo their what they are saying. So, what are the options available? Of course, open laparoscopic and robotic surgery, but there is no clear winner. Why? There is no consensus on which is the best, and it's always sort of a one-upmanship being tried here and there. The reason for that, perhaps, is there is no level one evidence. Randomized trials, and you know, I see here a lot of young minds. These ask questions. Sir, are there any possibility of randomized trial? And one of my resident came out with this, and he said, sir, BMJ in 2003 presented an observation that parachute use to prevent major trauma death in response to gravity force is a challenge, but their use has not been proved by randomized trial, but it's being used. So is there any possibility of having a randomized trial on radical prostatectomy? And that brings into another controversies, cost. Some of the people also tell us that robots saved my life. And of interest is this coming from Mount Sinai, that women feeling the difference with robotic surgery. Well, of course, this is for you to take where you are. Having said that, robotic surgery, again, thanks to antiquity, has really exponentially grown in this country. You've got more than 150 robotic surgeons, which is, of course, tribute to them. Not to really emphasize more than what is there, that's the advantage of robotic surgery in terms of 7 degrees of motion. Always there will be criticism for any new technology and the cost, haptic feedback. And of course, in a particular operation like radical prostatectomy, longer duration of the tendinopathic position. And of course, I want to bring into this point here, against by a guy from Canada, who talks about arguments against investing widely in robotic prostatectomy in Canada, a wrong focus on toolbox rather than the surgical expertise. So, what does it mean? What it means to a surgeon who is experienced in open surgery, it's never easy to, you know, take up a new procedure. There's also a point that you have to relive, not relieve, relive forgotten anxieties. And the most important thing is patient's expectations. And lastly, of course, not to forget about you've been teaching students, so you have to go back to the school, becoming resident again. But I think for all middle-aged and senior people, we have to forget about that. We must have, you know, to forget about these tremors and vision. Now, vision, I mean, not 3D vision of yourself. Some people have to undergo cataract surgery as well if you're using a robot, because central cataract can be a problem, and I did to myself as well. The most important thing is fear of open conversions, and reputation is at stake. Well, one of my younger mind told me that, sir, open radical prostatectomy is driving a Nano or a Maruti. And when you want to go to robotic surgery, it's like driving Ferrari. But he also said, can I drive directly a Ferrari from a bicycle, not to do open surgery? And yes, this is a question which is irrelevant, because younger generation is not seeing open radical prostatectomies now. It's going to be in the days, and in fact, when I was chairing with Jay Smith, and he also said me the same thing. At my department, there are no open radical surgeons now. And that's where it is. Then the question about, we talked about learning curve. Open radical prostatectomy, there used to be a dogma that 30 radical prostatectomy to be assisted before you really can take it up, especially DVC complex. Now, in India, those people who do not see open radical prostatectomy, can they ever take up robotic radical prostatectomy? The other question is, Suppose you have to convert it to open, what do we do? Do you call the people who are trained in that? Well, these are the questions which will remain till sine die. And of course, this is taken from Harry Potter. You will always get the help if you demand for it. And we discussed in the morning that cost and everything also matter. But what is important is not to forget about self-learning is dangerous. You must have a proctor. And as Dr. Mani Menon used to say, that at least 15 cases, for those people who are open trained surgeons, they must have a proctor for 15 cases and then go ahead and do that. Now, let me share and submit to you the experience. Back in 1996, at Tata Memorial, I started radical prostatectomy program with the help of Dr. Kamath then, and then the journey of two decades. Well, of course, I wish to bring to your data, head-to-head comparison of the data. The point I'm driving home is, this is open surgery in two institutions, Tata Memorial first 5 years, next 10 years, well, Bombay Hospital, which is a teaching institution, then comes robotic. Again, I must thank Dr. Bhandari, Asian Heart, SI system, and then from 2015 onwards, SHD. One of my residents was saying that, sir, you are driving Mercedes, now you are into nano. Quickly, the other veterinary guy quipped, but sir, you are also driving in the nano at the speed of Mercedes. So there's no problem. So from one way, the point I'm driving here, you should be in a position to do any machine. Although the fact is that higher versions are coming up. Now having said this, let's look at the small data here. Of course, robotic surgery only 400 plus, hospital stay, early complications, late complications, you can see for this. Now I'll go into the little details on that. This is for those who would like to know my experience of open surgery is already published. Suffice it to say, radical prostatectomy in different times, 96 to 2001, 2001 to 2010, and there onwards. There has been some complication, I must accept that. It's not that no complications occurred. Now let's look at the robotic figures. Well, of course, of interest, the point is we have got high-risk cases, which is almost one-fifth of the number of patients are high-risk group, which is Gleason score 8 and other things. Having said that, 17 patients had a major complications, and 2 patients had to have conversion. Conversion, I'm talking on table. For the reason, one was, of course, we really could not start because the adhesions were so well. And second, of course, the catheter walked out on the table. So I had no heart to really continue with this thing. I had to do open surgery. Blood transfusions, of course. But as these are all, let's not get into the numbers. Suffice it to say, as your technique improves, blood transfusions will require less. Now, at this point, I must like to say, when I shifted, and Somashekhar was one who will remember me, that I came to him from SI to SHD, and he showed me the things, and I said, all right, now I can go for SHD. The reason I'm saying here is, from SI, the blood loss came down to SHD. I do not know how to answer that question, but that happened. Now, let's look at the pathology. As you can see, the left side data, left side data is of the RALP and open RP. The difference is there, but not too much difference. It's merely pathological findings. Lymph node status, of course, there is some difference here and there. Now, that's the important point. Let's look at the continence rates. Now, at 1 month, the open surgery continence rate was 33%. The same at robotic surgery, 67%, double. At 3 months, 70 and 88, but later on the curve becomes the same thing. So essentially, we were gaining the continence much ahead of as compared to the open surgery. This is one positive finding which I saw. And when we compared with, of course, Menon and I just compared it because the number is very high, suffice it to say the same thing. The same thing, everybody said the same thing, that at 1 month, the continence rate improved with robotic surgery. Maybe better anastomosis, but you can't say that. Better anastomosis, open surgery as well. Now, surgical margins. Again, here open surgery, you can see 839 total cases, 22% open margins versus 14%. Again, these are all, that depends also the number of cases which are advanced cases which we are doing. We have one segment which is called post-TURB patients, and here I'll show you. open post-ERP patient, open RP, you see 25% margins high. Robotic, slightly high, but this is just one number case. So margin in TURP settings is going to be a little difficult, especially bladder neck margin. So therefore, there is going to be some more, as we experience improves, your margin rate will come down. Honestly speaking, I have no nerve-sparing data at all. Open surgery, I had about 45 patients, but really not much as far as the robotic surgery is concerned. So, jury is there, now come out. What have we achieved? And here it's less blood loss, less hospital stay, better continence at 1 month, better margin negativity, and above all, surgeon's comfort and less morbidity patient. Lymph node yield, well, I would say it can be a subject one, you can discuss. At 1 year, however, open surgery and robotic surgery are the same in terms of continence is concerned. So what is the take-home message? With changing times, we can never be old to learn. We must continue to learn. Skills must pass on to the younger guys. The another question is open RP is mandatory for a younger minds to take up robotic? Well, I think they have learned PCNL without doing open nephrolithotomy. So that should be possible. I suppose that should be possible. And the surgeon is more important than the tool. So it depends on you. And I will conclude by saying, well, Larry Klotz, who is the chairman of urological oncology of the world, a surgeon is the most important determinant of robotic radical prostatectomy outcomes of perioperative complications, length of stay, and stricture. Thank you very much.